Texas offer again, or Luna Lavender? Just wanted to come at y'all with your first lesson. Okay, it's exciting.
Are you ready to go crazy?
I'm already hearing voices.
Are you ready to...
SpongeBob, Patrick, don't you mind?
So this being our first lesson, I will try to have the intro just be a short little introduction, just basically saying, what are we doing? What's the purpose of what we're doing? And then we'll jump into the lesson. What we're doing today is we are going to look at song poetry. So when you guys go to the module, okay, and maybe I'll have a picture of it like here. The last lesson is Pompeii and the Eruption of Mount Vesuvius. That is an informational text to help you understand this song. You're probably wondering, because it's a very catchy song, that
this offered. This is not history class. We're listening to pop music.
Let me go ahead and just tell you. You might be surprised. Okay. So just letting you know that we will be doing the IC, I Think, I Wonder. And we are also going to be looking at the song. We're going to read it three times. So if you're ready, and a nice little jump cut, I think we'll probably jump into a nice little document of some sort so we can start reading for the first read-through. So when you are on Canvas, now I am in my little sandbox. This is like my pretend student account. So whenever you are on here as a student, you'll go to modules. You should see this week's, what should be say, it should say remote learning, poetry, and this week's dates of 3:30 through 4:30. Well, this can be done at your own rate whenever you want to, at your own pace. And you're going to actually, for our lesson here, I'm going to guide you through this. Now, before you do this, if you have not looked at these two first activities, you need to pause the video now and do these first two activities. This is really important. This is an informational text explaining about Pompeii, the historical significance, and what actually happened with Mount Vesuvius. You may have read and known some stuff about this, but I want to actually have you guys practice some informational text with this. Again, stop the video now, do these two things if you've not already done so. So if you have continued the video, I'm assuming you have already done these and you're ready for the guided lesson. So click on that. Please make sure, last week, one of the biggest things I noticed is that kids are not reading the instructions, and you need to make sure that you guys read these instructions. So the target for this will be, you see here, it says student will be able to read and analyze song poetry using the strategy I See, I Think, I Wonder. They will be able to identify figurative language, understand its meaning, and the ultimate theme of the song slash poem. I actually recommend kids read the entire thing first and then do this. So you're going to need to make a copy, watch the video or for the guided lesson to see how to analyze song poetry. I will actually turn this into a link so it is the actual video. I will guide you through the process of I See, I Think, I Wonder and how it can be applied to this song. Also, watch this music video for Pompeii by Bastille. This will help you to understand the theme. This will be for the I Wonder. All this information can be found on my webpage as well. Then at the bottom of the lyrics document, there are questions. So in this document number one, you'll see there's about three questions as I See, I Think, I Wonder. You need to answer all those questions that are found there. When you complete it, please submit it on Canvas. And this video here is how do you do it. Now we're going to open. You'll go up to File. Make a copy. All right. Some of y'all are just leaving it like this. I personally like to change it to this. It makes more sense to me to put your first name, last name. So now that you have your own copy of Pompeii and the song itself, now we can read it. You should definitely always try to read poetry three times at minimum. When we read it, you do the first time, you're looking for figurative language. So while we're reading it from top to bottom, I want you to be looking for just any examples of figurative language that pop out at you. You can use the highlighter tool right up here at the top, bold, italics, and underline the text color. Right there is the highlight color. If you want to grab the highlighter and highlight while we're reading, anything that kind of sticks out to you or anything that just looks interesting to you. So that's what you should do while I read the first time. Pompeii by Bastille. I was left to my own devices. Many days fell away with nothing to show. And the walls kept tumbling down,
in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How am I going to be an optimist about this? How am I going to be an optimist about this? We're caught up and lost in our own vices, in your pose as the dust settles around us. And the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Rain clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How am I going to be an optimist about this? How am I going to be an optimist about this? Oh, where do we begin? The rubble or our sins? Oh, where do we begin? The rubble or our sins? And the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Rain clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? How am I going to be an optimist about this? How am I going to be an optimist about this? But if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
But I always try to say, whenever we're looking at poetry, we should go ahead and at least understand the different parts of poetry. A row of words is a line, and a group of lines is a stanza. Let's go ahead and let's mark each stanza. So at the start of it, the first line where I was left to my own devices, put a one. Right here at the start of the next one, there will be always a space between the stanzas. And the walls kept tumbling down, put a two. And if I close my eyes, three. And so on and so forth. In total, you should have 9 stanzas. And if you look at here, I actually tried making it a little simpler for you guys to say, what do you guys see here? Do you guys see simile, personification, or illusion? Let's just start something simple. Do you guys see a simile? I probably could say right at the very top, you probably see a simile in stanza 3. But if you close your eyes, does it feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, you've been here before? I think that whole thing is going to be a simile. So, like I said, this is a great way using the highlighter tool to, and again, the highlighter tool is right up here next to the bold, italics, and underline, and the text tool, and there's a highlight tool. So I'm actually going to make it even easy on myself. I'm just going to copy and paste it. Copy. And paste it down there. So I see it there. And that's my simile down there. Now I need to look for personification. Personification is when you're given human-like qualities of something that is not human. So what is something that is not human that's given human-like characteristics? Many days fell away with nothing to show. In the first stanza, days can't fall away and they have nothing to show. I think humans can fall, and they can also show things. Like, especially they're saying, if you look at the whole stanza, I was left to my own devices. Many days fell away with nothing to show. I think the whole thing, I can actually add that to the I think, but I'll hold on to that. I'll come back to that in a second. So I think that would be an interesting thing to highlight. Let's make it blue. So coming down here, I'm going to copy it. I will put over here to the side. I'll say personification. There's an example right there. See, many days fell away with nothing to show. So the illusion. Remember, illusion is kind of like an inside joke. It's a direct reference to something historical, literary, something in the real world that exists in the real world. Look at the title. Pompeii. If you've done the assignment, this is why I said you had to do the assignment before this, the informational text. Now, some of you guys may know about the eruption of Mount Vesuvius, but if you did not, that would just completely go by you. You would have no idea. You'd have to go look it up. And even then, most y'all wouldn't even do that. That in itself is actually going to be that as well. And I would say that is the illusion. And I'm going to highlight that title. And I'm going to pop that right down there. Now we can get into the I think. Okay, this is when you're saying, what does this all mean? Now that we've finished the I see part of our reading, when you go back through and you're trying to read it for your second time, you're just basically asking yourself, what does this all mean? Okay, so you're saying, I think that the figurative language means blank. So our speaker, who is who this poem is about, or who this the person who is telling us this poem, is when he's using the simile, but if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? Now, if you imagine, this is why it was really important that you guys did watch and read about Pompeii and the eruption of Mount Vesuvius. Whenever you saw here in the second stanza, and the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. Great clouds roll over the hills, bringing darkness from above. You can imagine this is Mount Vesuvius erupting. And this is our speaker who may be in the middle of this cataclysmic event. He is in denial. He is pretending this is not happening. And so as this is like literally the end of his world, he's closing his eyes and pretending that nothing has changed at all. So that's what I would say, I think, for the simile. I'll say, the speaker is pretending that the destruction of Pompeii and the eruption of Mount Vesuvius is not happening around him by closing his eyes and pretending it's not happening. So moving on to the personification. So for the personification, it says, many days fell away with nothing to show. If we go back in the first stanza, it says, I was left to my own devices. Many days fell away with nothing to show. I got started almost thinking about that. Days can't fall away, and they can't show anything. So what is he really trying to say here? So I, being our speaker, he said, I was left to my own devices. You can imagine, if I, in a classroom, that if I left the kids, you guys, to your own devices, literally, like your computers, maybe your own devices, and I just said, be good, don't do anything you're not supposed to, especially those games, you can imagine that not a lot of work would be done unless I was in there watching. So our speaker here is left to his own devices. He's not getting much done. The days fell away with nothing to show. He's just not being very productive. He's doing nothing good. He's not doing anything bad. He's just doing nothing. So I would just say that personification. The speaker has wasted many days doing nothing. Which kind of now has a bigger picture here that you can kind of imagine that in that first stanza, he's wasted a lot of time doing nothing, and now the eruption of Mount Vesuvius is happening. Pompeii is being destroyed around him. And what does he have to show for his life? Nothing. Now we're starting to get a bigger story, and we're getting a more interesting kind of idea of what this whole song is about. So the illusion is, that's probably the simplest. The title is alluding / referencing to the historical event of the destruction of Pompeii and eruption of Mount Vesuvius. So now we're ready for the final step, which is the I wonder. So now we're getting into the theme. So this is where I will be pausing, and I won't be playing the music video straight through. So I would actually pause the video, click on the music video, and watch it. It's probably gonna. I wanted to give a fair warning before you guys watch the video. It is maybe slightly freaky. If you are freaked out by eyes being slightly different colors, I know there's a filter on TikTok right now where they make eyes black. If that freaks you out, I apologize in advance. But you really probably should just try to swallow it down and watch it, because it'll help you to understand. There's a deeper theme here. Remember, theme is a message, a lesson, something that the poet here wants you to learn and take away from and can apply to your life. Because right now you're kind of like, okay, well, our speaker is just living in ancient Pompeii, ancient Roman times. It doesn't apply to my life. How can that apply to our lives?
It's interesting to note that in the music video that the city is not modern day Pompeii, or it's not actually pastime Pompeii. It is not historical Pompeii. It looks like a modern day city like Los Angeles. Our main character is in definitely an area that doesn't look very nice. There's a lot of things that looks very old. It doesn't look very clean. And as he's riding through the city, you'll notice that, again, it's very run down, very neglected looking, and there's trash everywhere. Now, when he goes into the store, he walks into this restaurant store, and he's looking around for someone, and he picks up a drink. And when he goes up to pay for it, there's a lady there, and it's very interesting that she has black eyes. Now, why is it that she has black eyes? So, what do you think is probably preventing her from improving the city? Because in a way, the city, unlike Pompeii, which was falling down and being destroyed by a volcano, this city is falling apart and being destroyed by a different thing. Possibly, maybe neglect and trash. What could be preventing her from going out and fixing the city? Could it be money? Being obsessed about her restaurant. So what Bastille has done is very interesting to show her. They kind of made it literal by showing her with black eyes. It's just an interesting choice on their part to show the black eyes as them ignoring the problem of the city falling apart. And you'll notice that he runs away. Every time he runs into somebody with these black eyes, he runs away. And there's trash everywhere in all the videos. He runs across a couple. And they're making out. Are they fixing the problem? No. They have black eyes. They are just obsessed about each other. So he goes to an arcade. He runs in there. And this is where a lot of times I apologize if I show this image and some of y'all get a little freaked out. But this is actually, and again, in the music video, you could say this is an illusion. If anybody has ever seen The Shining. This scene, there is these two girls in front of a video screen, video game, and what do they have? The black eyes as well. Why? What's preventing them from going out and fixing the city? Could it be video games? Again, not necessarily saying video games are bad. It's just saying, could there be a reason why they're ignoring the problem? Could it be the video games? It could be. And of course, our main character here in the video, he continues to run away. So the next guy we run into here in a moment, he's going to be out there smoking, and he has blood all over his face. And it's very interesting that he has blood all over his face and that he's smoking. You could say why he's not fixing the problem. Maybe he has a drug addiction. Maybe he's involved in some kind of violence. Maybe crimes. There's a lot of things you can get from this image alone. Just saying, how come he's not fixing the city? He could be very much maybe makes the city worse. We don't know. But at the very least, he's not helping it out, so he has the black eyes as well. So our main character, he keeps running, and his eyes are not black. It's interesting that his eyes are not black. It's almost like he sees the problem, and he knows what needs to be done, but he continues to just run away. And now he's running away with a car. And you can tell he's very upset because he starts hitting the car. He gets out. He's having almost like a temper tantrum. You know that he is very upset and angry that this problem is happening. But is he really doing anything about it? No, not really. And it's interesting that his eyes, it's kind of an interesting moment. His eyes start to turn black. But he continues doing the same thing. We're no longer in the city. We're running away. We're where the windmills are. And he's going into the desert. And he runs some more. It's almost interesting that he's leaving the city and going towards nature. In a lot of ways, we're almost taught in Western society that that's kind of a good thing. Leave the city and go into nature. But the problem is the city still there? Is the problem still there? Yes. So therefore, at the end of the video, when he turns around, even though he's in a good place, his eyes are black as well. Interesting yet creepy moment that Bastille leaves us on. Problems do not go away. You gotta face your problems. It's almost like Lion King, whenever he gets smacked on the head, you know, saying the past can hurt, but you know, you can either run from it, or you can learn from it. And that's kind of here with the same, almost same idea, that the problems don't go away. In the music video, you see that the city is literally falling to pieces around our speaker, around the other characters who are being distracted by video games, by love, by money, by drugs. They're being distracted, and yet even our speaker is distracted by getting angry and then running away from it. But the problems are still there. Problems do not go away. So what do we do with that? What is that? It's basically kind of an open-ended, what do you do with a problem? Do you just leave it there to continue to be a problem? Or is it more of a, I think this is more where the speaker is trying to challenge us to not just let, you know, let us be a continuation of ignoring problems. We got to go out and fix these problems. So hopefully this was an interesting little deep dive into a pop song you've definitely heard on the radio a few times. That, you know, like I said, its lesson is that problems do not go away and we need to rise up and face them and fix them.
I was left to my own divine, Isis. Many days fell away with nothing to show.